You have an OpenLayers map with some features on a vector layer and you want to create a fancy hover effect to highlight the features, but you don't know how to do it? Then you should watch this video. I'll show you how to easily create such behavior and, spoiler alert, it's pretty easy. Let's get started. Before we can start implementing a hover effect in OpenLayers, we need to do one important thing. We need to create a new OpenLayers project. I'm going to do this by simply following the steps of the OpenLayers Quick Start Guide, which creates this nice little web application that already contains a map with an OpenStreetMap layer, so we have a pretty good starting point. Now we need some actual data, some features we want to show on our map, which can be highlighted when the mouse is over a feature. For this, I will use a GeoJSON file that I downloaded from geojson.xyz. I have chosen the file admin1states-provinces, but of course you can use any other data, you just need the data in a form that you can use in a vector layer. Then we need to add a vector layer to the OpenLayers map that will display the GeoJSON data. For a vector layer, we need a vector source, so we create that first. We specify the features for the vector source by using the GeoJSON format to read the features from the GeoJSON file. Then we create a vector layer where we do nothing more than specify the vector source. After that, we can add the layer to the map and admire the result in the browser. Now let's add some styling to the vector layer. There are a few different ways to add custom styling. I will just specify a style function on the vector layer that expects the feature to style as a function parameter. This way we can create a style that depends on the feature itself. First, I will create a simple style that does not take the feature into account, so this will be the style for the unhighlighted features. And the result looks like this. Very simple. The next step is to add a handler for the pointer move event to the map. In the handler function, we iterate over all features of the vector source and the mouse position and set isActive to true. Then, you probably guessed it, we go back to the style function and check if the feature has isActive set to true. If it is, we know that this feature is highlighted. So we need to specify the highlighting style. I will do this by adding a text showing the name, making the borderline a little thicker, and adding a semi-transparent fill. Let's see how this looks in the browser. Initially, all features are unhighlighted. When I move the mouse over a feature, it will be highlighted. But we also see a problem. When I move the mouse away from a feature, it stays highlighted. And there's a simple explanation for this. IsActive is never set back to false. So let's fix that. I create an array to which I add all the features I want to highlight. Then, at the beginning of the pointer move handler function, I iterate over the old highlighted features and set isActive to false. Then, I empty the array. And that's it. Let's go back to the browser and check the result. I move the mouse over a feature, it is highlighted. I move the mouse away, it is no longer highlighted. Perfect. And that's it. A super fancy effect that took only a few lines of code to implement. What do you think of this implementation? Let me know in the comments. Well, that's it for this video. Maybe you are also interested in how to use OpenLayers in a Blazor project. If so, you can watch this video next. Thanks for watching. Bye.